This is Bulldog Bill Feingold. The place to be Saturday mornings at 9 o'clock is the open air market in Cathedral City, where we shoot What's It Worth Palm Springs. If you want sunglasses, fresh fruits and vegetables, candles, clothing, artwork, this is the place to be on Saturdays, the open air market in Cathedral City, right across from Target and Trader Joe's. Our next guest is Norman. Hi, Norman.
How are you today?
I'm doing great. What did you bring us? Where'd you get this rifle? It's obviously a rifle.
It's a rifle, and it came from my wife's mother.
Your wife's mother?
And yeah, her mother, and it came to her mother from grandparents before them.
Well, I thought she pulled it out when you said you get married.
No, that was another day.
That was another time. Okay, well, Kyle will tell you all about the rifle.
Good.
It's a classic late 19th century Colt rifle. Colt firearms, of course, are very, very famous. You can see here it's marked 22 caliber. And then on this section of the octagonal bore here, you can see the full name, Colt Patent, Manufacturing. This piece was patent dated between 1883 and 1887, you can see on here. And it had quite a long production history. It was known as the Colt Lightning Slide Action Short Frame Rifle.
Okay, Kyle got that out. Can you believe it?
There's large frames, medium frame, and this is the small frame. It was basically produced between about 1887 and 1904. Mm-hmm. And values range according to condition. This is really excellent condition. The inscription's good. The walnut's all in excellent condition. It hasn't been refinished, which is very important.
Hasn't been used lately.
I'd probably hold off doing that. Basically, these on the gun market that I was able to research are generally valued in the $275 to $375 range. Obviously, Colt was a very prolific maker, and this being produced for a long time isn't a really rare example, but is a very fine example of what it is.
Is that good news?
Why not? I think so. Yeah.
You're going to keep it, though, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Family
put it in the
heirloom.
Front door.
Yeah, we'd park it by the front door. It'd be a door jam.
Okay. Thanks for coming down today.
Thank you for being here. Thank you for the value of the gun.
Thanks. Everybody's talking about the open air market Saturdays in Cathedral City, right across from Target and Trader Joe's. We're here every Saturday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., where you get great buys on clothing, jewelry, artwork, fruits and vegetables. This is the place to be on Saturdays, the open air market in Cathedral City, across from Target and Trader Joe's. Come on out, meet the Bulldog, and see What's It Worth Palm Springs. Welcome, Martha from Palm Springs.
Hello.
Nice to meet you. What'd you bring us today?
I brought some heirlooms from my grandmother. Ooh. The first thing is the hair collector. And this is, in those days, people brushed their hair a lot, and they didn't have waste paper baskets and other things. And so the women would put their hair in receivers. And this is a receiver, a silver receiver, with her initials on it. And so it was very specifically hers.
Don't people brush their hair nowadays? You said in the old days they used to brush their hair a lot.
Yeah, I don't think they washed it quite as much in those days, and they brushed it a lot every night. Yeah. You know, we don't tend to do that.
No, we don't do that.
Yes.
What's this?
And this is a piece made during her lifetime of the hair.
Oh, wow.
So, nice. And so I came to see, because this is, no one seems to know what this is when I wear it.
Right, right. Well, it's, as we were talking about earlier, it's one of these things that, very, very Victorian. This is obviously known as hair jewelry, and it had a long span of popularity from about 1850 to probably the 1890s, and sometimes it was a home craft. They actually had plans in ladies' magazines telling them how to do the weaving, that type of thing. This probably was done by a professional, because you can see the fine workmanship. Every one of those strands is a human hair that was woven, in this case, in the shape of an acorn and mounted in this, it's probably 10 karat gold pin. And for years and years, this has obviously been in the collector's market, But as I was explaining to Martha earlier, there hasn't been a real demand for it, strangely.
Maybe we could start at hair jewelry.
Well, there is actually, I believe, in the last 10, 15 years, it has begun to catch on. And when you go to shows with antique jewelry, you'll often see a number of hair jewelry pieces. They have very simple pieces like just little band bracelets. They did earrings with acorns. This is a pin. They did some necklaces. But obviously, it's very fragile. And so it's remarkable that it has survived this long. This is even in an early leather case, and you have the wonderful history with it, with the actual hair receiver. As you said, that good, you know, Victorian ladies, this is what they did on their dresser sets. In checking into this piece, this particular pin, it's in good condition. There might be a few fragments on it, but this could easily sell in the $350 to $450 range. In the jewelry market.
Is that good news, Martha?
That's good news, yeah. Although it's kind of priceless to me.
Sure.
So yeah, it'll probably be passed to my daughter.
Hopefully it will. Keep it in the family with the wonderful story behind it.
Tell her not to shampoo it.
Okay, I will. I will. She has really long curly hair.
Ah, there
so
we go.
So she needs the receiver.
You told your daughter to brush her hair a lot.
Yes, I have.
But you have beautiful hair.
Oh, thank you.
But I never heard of hair jewelry before.
Well, it's been around since really the 18th century, and a lot of people think of it, they think it's from people that are deceased.
Right.
Because in the 18th and through the 19th century, things like rings and little pins were often memorial pieces where they had a woven piece with the deceased person's hair. But a vast majority of the hair jewelry was done with living hair.
Well, thanks for bringing it in, Martha. I learned
Thank
a lot.
You. Thank you. I learned a lot, too. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Well, that's it for this week's show. Please join us every Saturday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. right here in the open air market in Cathedral City across from Trader Joe's and Target. What's it worth, Palm Springs? Follow us. We have a website. You can put your items on to sell them. Watch the scroll at the end of the show, and we'll see you next week.